Welcome back, students. So today's standard 10th English medium, we are going to learn new poem. That is unit number 4. Okay, 4.4. The height of the ridiculous. The name of the poem is The Height of the Ridiculous, and the poet of this poem is Oliver Wendell Holmes. Okay. Students, how funny is the poem? So let's begin with poem and come to know how or what poet want to say regarding his poem. So through the poem you are going to learn. The start, the height of the ridiculous. We'll go through the poem. I wrote some lines once on a time in wondrous merry mood, and thought as usual mean would say they were exceeding good. So what happened here, students, in the first stanza, what poet says, a poet had written some lines with his very wondrous, with his happy mood. So when poet was very happy, that delightful, and that time he wrote some lines, means poem, as usual men would say they were, and what he was thinking, and poet thought the common reader as usual will say that lines are exceeding very, very good. Next stanza. They were so queer, so very queer, I laughed as I would die, albeit in the general way, a sober man am I. So in second stanza, what poet says? Poet says, they mean, sir, what? That they mean that lines which poet has written. So that lines are very queer. Very queer means very strange, very unknown, very strange, very strange. So repetition there, queer and queer. I laugh as I would die. So what poet says here? So poet says when he read that poem, so he may be die. He would die by reading these lines. It means that lines were very humorous. Albeit means though, if in the general way, a sober man I am. So what poet considered? So poet thought himself he is a very sober, very good nature, very having the good heart. So he is very as a good, as a sober man, but he would die when read that lines. So the next stanza, what poet says, here we comes to know, die, I, just some rhyming words from the second stanza. In first stanza, mood, good, like this is the rhyming words, not rhyming pair is there. Now see, in third stanza, what poet want to say, convey us, I called my servant and he came, how kind it was of him to mind a slender man like me. He of the mighty limbs. So what your poet says, when poet says he called his servant and he came, by calling the poet's call, that servant came to the poet, and how kind it was of man. So he what says, he told about the servant, how the servant was very kind, who took care of the poet always, to mind a slender man like me. So to mind means here to take care, mind to take care. So to take care of such kind of man means the poet, he of the mighty limb. What is this? Poet compare himself with the servant. He means that poet is very thin, slight, not a very strong like his servant. And his servant is very strong. Okay, mighty limb means his organs, body organs become very strong, very mighty. In next stanza, here we come to know the rhyming words. Him, limb, just some rhyming words. Okay, it means poets compare himself, not compare, but he says poet is feeling he is weaker than his servant. It means servant is strong. Next stanza. This to the printer, I exclaimed, and in my humorous way, I added as a clean, just. There will be, but they will to pay. What does poet says? Poet says, to the right, to the servant, take this, this means that lines, and to go to the printer. Okay, of course, poet is a poet, and whatever he has written, he wants to print it. So he told his servant, go to printer and print out it. He excellent. I mean, said poet, and in my humorous way, as a humorous, the poet says, in my humorous way, I added as a tripinja. Tripinja ne kya ki? Just a small simple joke. As a joke, there will be the devil to pay. So that devil, though her, the reader, they will pay, they can buy this because the printing lines. Next answer, he took the paper and I watched and saw him peep within. So what poet said in next stanza, when that writer gave his lines to the servant, when that servant peeped out, that servant had a look on that lines. So what he thought? I watched and saw him peep within. At the first line he read, his face was all upon the green. So what poet said? When first line was read by the servant, and his face looked like a green, like a smiling, which means with a happy, not a happy, but as a laugh. So as the next stanza, he took the paper and watched and saw him peep within, meaning looking towards that lines on the paper, and he saw him peep within. At the first line he read, his face was upon a green. Green means laugh. At the first line, the servant started laughing. And short form ear to ear, but next, he read the next, the green grew broader. When he read the next line, again his laugh groan. Means he started laughing very loudly. Grew ear to ear, that broad. And short from ear to ear, he read the third, that now that servant read the third lines, a chuckling noise I now begin to hear. On what kind of noise? It's a chuckling means, you know, with stopping, with laughing, with stopping, means such a kind of chuckling, very noise, very slowly to hear. There is onomatopoeia, which figure of speech is there, because that word creates a sound. That's why it's a onomatopoeia, chuckling noise. Next line, the fourth he broke into roar, the fifth his waistband split. And what happened when he read that fourth line? He broke into roar means very, he started very loudly to laugh. And when he read the fifth lines, his waistband split, and waistband, that belt which we use for the pant, that is waist, that slipped out because of that laughing noise, because of that his activity, that laughing activity. The sixth, he burst with buttons and tumbled in a fit. And when he read the sixth lines, what happened, that servant, he laughed very loudly and burst from his button of his shirt because of that laughing, his buttons, and tumbled in a fit and became unconscious because of such a kind of laughing, such kind of laugh, become unconscious and felt on the floor, and felt on the floor. It means you can imagine how humorous the lines may be there. That's why he, the servant's condition is there. He became felt on the ground, on that floor. Next stanza, 10 days and nights with sleepless eye, I watched that wretched man. So what here poet say in the next line? How many days he became unconscious? 10 days and nights. Who the servant? With sleepless eyes. And then I watched that wretched man. Wretched man means very here helpless condition. So poet saw his servant in helpless condition. And since I never dared to write as funny as I can. And from that moment, since that time, poet did not dare to write such a kind of humorous, such a kind of comedies, we can say funny poem as he can. So next stanza, that is a rhyming word, I, okay, sorry, man and can. So in this way we can say, this is a very humorous poem that poet has written, that lines which creates here very fun, and here mention as the condition of each servant. So students, I hope you understood it, and if you like this video, you can share it, you can like it and also subscribe it. Thanks for watching.